The Philippine Stock Exchange closes the first half of the year in the red. The main index shed nearly 0.7% to close at 64.68 on Friday. Value turnover was at 4.7 billion pesos. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Nisha Alicer, Chief Equity Strategist at DA Market Securities. Again, Nisha, glad to have you on the show.
Thank you for having me, Stanley.
Okay, at opening today, we saw the market trying to defend the 6,500 support, but it looks like the bears are in control. Now, is this the end, Nisha, of the very short bullish streak we've experienced recently?
Sure. I'd like to look at it in a way that we saw net foreign buying come in at those support levels. So for this period, we've been looking at 6,300 and hasn't even touched that or even the 6,000 level. So in fact, we think that the market, because of this, looks more bullish. Of course, in terms of how fast it can go to ascend to the higher levels of resistances is still a bit uncertain.
And you're saying you're seeing improvement in foreign buying?
Yes, at least for the past week, about 1.5 billion net foreign buying. Not so significant yet, but definitely green shoots of optimism.
All right, Nisha, what's your assessment of the first 6 months of trading for the year 2023? And perhaps what weighed down on sentiment for most investors through the 6 months?
Sure. Year to date, if we look at those figures just for the 6 months, we're definitely seeing a flat market. But because the market really comes in cycles, you have to consider what really happened in September, October, where, you know, most of the dips really happened. And therefore, if you count it coming from that low, about 5,700, market has actually returned about 14% on average. Safe to say, you know, higher returns of individual stocks. So I think what happened was, you know, a bit more profit taking in the first part of the year coming from that low. But at the same time, we're looking forward to a rebalancing of portfolio. So having seen, you know, earnings reports and forecasts for the rest of the year towards next year, we think that there is a lot of things to be excited about the market. Of course, growth has to be, optimism for growth has to be a bit tempered in terms of how fast it can happen.
All right, so much has changed from the lows of October up until we opened the year in January. Now, in terms of growth, we're finishing the first 6 months of the year still down 1% from that January level. Now, we're aspiring to end 2023 at 7,000. Now, Nisha, what's a more realistic expectation for growth in the Philippine market? How do you think we would finish this year?
Sure, I wouldn't discount reaching 7,000. I think that is still possible for the year. So that's about 8% increase. There is a little bit of like a sentiment that has made some investors sad about how there's companies that are delisting, and that's been a trend that we've seen recently. And so, you know, we definitely want a deeper market. And so, that's another thing that we'll have to keep a watch on. It is important to have a bigger market because that also attracts foreign investors. We think that we have to kind of wait out how this year will pan out, because we think that maybe next year would present better opportunities.
Now, it's sad to see that a lot of companies are feeling that they are unappreciated by the market. And really, when you talk about Brit, for the past 6 months, it's really been just a few counters doing really well. We have banking, we have consumer counters. The others are not as dynamic as they're supposed to. Now, Nisha, for the next 6 months, what sectors do you expect to remain sluggish, at least for the rest of the year?
Sure. So inflation continues to be a concern. However, it is tapering down. But as the news has come out, there's higher possible minimum wages. It could affect employment, or it could affect company earnings. So that's definitely something to keep a watch on. And it would affect consumer plays. However, we do see it as an opportunity to come and buy back into those sectors should they dip, particularly the ones that are not just affected locally, but are expanding globally. And so, I mean, Jollibee, for example, actually has been a strong stock, and that would be interesting to see should there be a dip in that. Mining has continued to stay kind of really slow, and then also, I would say those would be the slow ones. But conversely, we do like what we're seeing in power. I think it's really quite exciting, the renewable energy space. The fact that it not only is it a sustainable investment, but also because it does make sense at current energy prices to get into renewable. It's becoming more affordable because of the technology, because of the players that are coming in. Prices are becoming very competitive. And then, you know, additionally, we do like the stable choices like dividend paying stocks, logistics is going to be quite exciting for years to come.
What about property? Are you seeing growth in the next 6 months? Is it recovering?
Property, we are interested in positioning, accumulating, but we do not expect it to be that quick. Although next year, I think we would see some pickup already. And we've heard that also from the property companies.
All right. Lastly, it's the president's first year in office. What did investors like about the way he has managed the economy? And perhaps which areas do you think remain a challenge for his economic managers moving forward?
Sure. I think agriculture remains to be a concern. It's food security. It affects inflation a lot. It affects the dynamics among countries. And, you know, it will always be an ongoing concern for the country. So I think that one has yet to be really addressed. At the same time, though, we've seen like pledges of investments from China into the electric vehicle space, mineral processing, and also agriculture. So while these are great pledges that we're hearing about, this happened also in the previous administration. And we don't want to get into a pledge trap. We don't want to get into a debt trap. So we definitely have to monitor how execution moves forward and if the pledges actually materialize.
All right, Nisha Alicer of DA Market Securities, thanks again for joining us this afternoon and for your market guidance.
You're welcome. Thank you, Stanley.